sunrise. The light is very dim, very, very dim. So don't try to shoot it handheld because you're going to get some camera shake most likely. Or unless you boost up the ISO too high and then you get a lot of noise. During the golden hours, you have very dim light. It's better to be on a tripod.
Been there like at the beginning of winter, and it's yes. Just incredible. I don't have to tell you, but
composition,
yes.
There's two Crestacaracaras. So there, you see that the cypress tree, there's a wood stork, and then just below it on the right is a Caracara, and then the tree over, which you gotta come over this way.
Caracaras, two.
Where? Two of them.
Over there.
Wood stork.
That's pretty creative.
I've got some.
So what are you doing there?
This is my poor man's telephoto lens.
All right, cool. And combining binoculars with
a point and shoot, with just a simple Olympic point and shoot, and I get some good, some decent shots. Yeah.
How's it been so far?
Terrific. Very, very enjoyable.
Yeah? What did you see? Any particular birds?
American kestrels, red-shouldered hawks, little blue heron, tricolored heron,
kingfishers.
Those are a little tougher
to get. Limpkins, bantleagrets, great egrets, blue herons.
Caracara, you saw the one flying?
No.
Oh, we're going to get to that one.
No, I missed that.
Hopefully we'll get to that.
Yes.
Really want that.
Sandhill cranes.
Oh, wow.
The Northern Harrier?
In this area, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And then flying over this way too.
Just flew.
No, that wasn't a phoebe. Yeah, that was not a phoebe.
Yay! Yeah.
Space, I want to prop in the mid-tone.
So the final image